So we're beginning from the chapter 1 of the Bhagavad Gita, very first sloka. This is one of the memorization slokas. People who are studying Bhakti Shastri, they will have to memorize this
sloka.
Dhritarashtra Vajja
Dhritarashtra Vajja
Dhamma Kshetra Kuru Kshetra
Dhamma Kshetra Kuru Kshetra
Dhamma Veta Yuyatava
Dhamma Veta Yuyatava
Mahaka Pandava Jaiva
Mahaka Pandava Jaiva
Kimma Kurvata Sanjaya Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samma Veta Yuyutsava
Samma Veta Yuyutsava
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Mamaka
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samma Veta Yuyutsava
Samma Veta Yuyutsava
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Mamaka
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samaveta Yutsava
Samaveta Yutsava
Mamakaha Pandavas Chaiva
Mamakaha Pandavas Chaiva
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samaveta Yuyutsavah
Samaveta Yuyutsavah
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Kim Kurvata Sanjaya
Kim Kurvata Sanjaya
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samaveta Yuyutsava
Samaveta Yuyutsava
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Kim Kuruvat Sanjaya
Kim Kuruvat Sanjaya
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samaveta Yuyutsava
Samaveta Yuyutsava
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Kim Akurvata Sanjaya
Kim Akurvata Sanjaya
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samaveta Yuyutsava
Samaveta Yuyutsava
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Mamaka Pandavas Chaiva
Kim Akurvata Sanjaya
Kim Akurvata Sanjaya
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dhritarashtra Uvacha
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre
Samaveta Yuyustabha
Samaveda Yuyustabha
Mama Kesh Pandava Chava
Mama Ka Pandava Chava
Hema Hema Kurvata Sanjaya
Hema Kurvata Sanjaya
Dika Vata Vata
Dika Vata
集结在圣地库鲁施特拉之后做了什么？
purport by His Divine Grace is the Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Bhagavad Gita is the widely read theistic science summarized in the Gita Mahatmya, glorification of the Gita. There it says that one should read Bhagavad Gita very scrutinizingly with the help of a person who is a devotee of Sri Krishna and try to understand it without personal motivated interpretations. The example of clear understanding is there in the Bhagavad Gita itself, in the way the teaching is understood by Arjuna, who heard the Gita directly from the Lord. If someone is fortunate enough to understand the Bhagavad Gita in that line of the cyclic succession without motivated interpretation, then he surpasses all studies of Vedic wisdom and all scriptures of the world. One will find in the Bhagavad Gita all that is contained in other scriptures, but the reader will also find things which are not to be found elsewhere. That is the specific standard of the Gita. It is the perfect theistic science, because it is directly spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Sri Krishna. The topics discussed by Dhritarashtra and Sanjay, as described in the Mahabharata, form the basic principle for this great philosophy. It is understood that this philosophy evolved on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, which is a sacred place of pilgrimage. From the immemorial time of the Vedic age, it was spoken by the Lord when he was present personally on the planet for the guidance of mankind. The word Dharmakshetra is a place where religion, where religious rituals are performed, is significant, because on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead was present on the side of Arjuna. Dhritarashtra, the father of the Kurus, was highly doubtful about the possibility of his son's ultimate victory. In his doubt, he inquired from his secretary Sanjay, what did they do? He was confident that both his sons and the sons of his younger brother Pandu were assembled in that field of Kurukshetra for a determined engagement of the war. Still, his inquiry is significant. He did not want a compromise between the cousins and brothers, and he wanted to be sure of the fate of his sons on the battlefield, because the battle was arranged in to be fought at Kurukshetra, which is mentioned elsewhere in the Vedas as a place of worship, even for the denizens of heaven. Dhritarashtra became very fearful about the influence of the holy place on the outcome of the battle. He knew very well that this would influence Arjuna and the sons of Pandu favorably, because by nature they were all virtuous. Sanjay was a student of Vyasa, and therefore, by the mercy of Vyasa, Sanjay was able to envision the battlefield of Kurukshetra, even while he was in the room of Dhritarashtra. And so Dhritarashtra asked him about the situation on the battlefield. Both the Pandavas and the sons of Dhritarashtra belong to the same family, but Dhritarashtra's mind is disclosed herein. He deliberately claimed only his sons as Kurus, and he separated the sons of Pandu from the family heritage. One can thus understand the specific position of Dhritarashtra in his relationship with his nephews, the sons of Pandu. As in the paddy field, the unnecessary plants are taken out, so it is expected from the very beginning of these topics that in the religious field of Kurukshetra, where the father of religion, Sri Krishna, was present, the unwanted plants like Dhritarashtra's son, Duryodhana, and others would be wiped out, and the thoroughly religious persons headed by Yudhisthira would be established by the Lord. This is the significance of the word Dharmakshetra and Kurukshetra, apart from their historical and deep importance.
国家梵歌进行摘要并指出，人们应该在圣Krishna奉献者的帮助下仔细阅读国家梵歌，应该尝试不带个人动机的去理解它。国家梵歌里有如何清楚的去理解它的实例，例如阿朱娜通过直接从至尊祖那里聆听国家梵歌而理解了它的教诲。人如果有幸能在师父传承中理解国家梵歌，不带个人动机的去解释它，将胜于研究所有的Veda知识，学习世上所有的经典。读者会发现，国家梵歌不仅包含了所有其他经典的内容，也包含了其他经典所没有的内容。这就是国家梵歌的特点。国家梵歌因为是至尊人格首身圣主Krishna直接讲述的，所以是完美的有关神的科学。在摩诃婆罗多中所描述的Dhritarashtra和Sanjaya谈话的主题，构成了这门伟大科学的基本原理。这门科学是至尊主为指导人类而在这个地球上亲自讲述的。自远古的 Veda 时代以来，至尊主讲述这门哲学的地方 Kurukshetra 战场就一直是个圣地，举行宗教仪式的地方 Dharmakshetra 具意义重大，因为在库鲁战场上，至尊人格首神站在阿朱那一边。Dhritarashtra 很怀疑他儿子们是否能取得最后的胜利，因此疑惑地问着秘书 Sanjaya 他们做了什么。他确信弟弟潘度的儿子和自己的儿子之所以聚集在库鲁战场上，是为了决一死战。他提出这个问题是有用意的，他不希望儿子们对侄子们妥协，想明确地知道儿子们在战场上的命运。战争安排在库鲁之野这个韦达经中提到的圣地进行的，连天堂星球的居民也来此朝圣。 Dhritarashtra 一直害怕圣地会影响战争的结局，他清楚地知道由于 Arjuna 和 Pandu 的其他的儿子天生品德高尚，圣地将会对他们有利。Sanjaya 是 Vyasa 的学生，他凭借着老师的仁慈，能坐在 Dhritarashtra 的房间里观看着战场上的一切，因此 Dhritarashtra 向他询问战场上的情况。 Pandava 兄弟与 Dhritarashtra 的儿子们本属同一个家族，但 Dhritarashtra 通过故意只把自己的儿子称为 Kuru 来把潘度的儿子与家族继承权分开， 从而暴露了他的用心。我们在此可以看出 Dhritarashtra 与他的侄子潘度之子的特殊关系。在事件上一开始就可以预料，当宗教之父圣 Krishna 在出现在的库鲁之野这片宗教的土地上时，就像杂草一样的把 Dhritarashtra 的儿子 Duryodhana 及其他人则被避位铲除。Yudhishthira 为首的前进之士必恢复他们合法的地位。谁有宗教仪式的地方 Dharmakshetri 和在名叫库鲁的地方 Kurukshetri 这两句话，除了具有历史上和伟大文化上的重要性之外，还有这样的深刻含义。
Om Jnana Tumarandasya Jnana Jnana Sadhyaya Chakshurmilam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadhamayam Dadati SwapadantrikamVandeham Shri Guru Shri Yatha Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamsya Shri Rupam Saprachatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sachevam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parjana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanitamscha Hey Krishna Karna Sindhu Dhinabandhu Jagatpate Govisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Tata Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakarpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vayepacha Patitanam Pahanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So the verse spoken here today is spoken by Dhritarashtra, who is not at Kurukshetra, he's at Hastinapur, he's in his palace.
所以今天这个部分呢，就是说这个Dhritarashtra 在讲话，但是他当时没有在库鲁这个战场上，他是在 Hastinapur 他的宫殿里面自己的房间里。
So Kurukshetra is an important holy place.Not only for the speaking of the Bhagavad Gita, there's another reason why Kurukshetra is also important.
这个库鲁之野是一个非常重要的地方，因为不只是说国家梵歌在这边讲述，还有另外的因素。
Kurukshetra was place where the first Rathyatra took place.
库鲁这个地方是弹车节第一次进行的地方。
It's the only place outside of Vrindavan where Lord Krishna meets with Srimati Radharani.
是唯一呢，在 Vrindavan 之外的地方 ，Krishna 跟 Radharani 会面的地方。
So it's a very, very sacred holy place for the devotees. So Prabhupada wanted to establish a temple there.
对奉献者来讲，这个地方是非常神圣的地方，所以 Prabhupada 也要。我们在那边建盖出庙来。
So under the direction of His Holiness Gopal Krishna Goswami, the devotees have managed to secure land and a temple is going under construction.
所以呢，由着圣 Gopal Krishna Maharaj 的这个仁慈，然后去那边把那个地方呢，采购下来，而且保护那个地方，就在现在在盖着庙宇。
So Kurukshetra is also Dharmakshetra. It's a place of pilgrimage, an important place of pilgrimage. It's not just only a place for war.
库鲁之野呢，不只是就是一个很特别神圣的地方，不只是作战的地方，而且是神圣的地方。
But it was decided that the Pandavas and the Kauravas that they would meet together, they would fight, they would have the battle there at that place. They had selected that
place.当时他们选择就潘度这个这些孩子们呢，还有另外一边这些亲族的嘛，在那边见会面。And
the Pandavas, it's in their favor, of course, because they're virtuous people, they're pious people. So the fact that the battle is taking place in a holy place is to the favor of the Pandavas, unlike the sons of Dhritarashtra, who are not so pious.
那这场战争呢，是在这里库鲁这个地方发生的，是由于因为潘度的这个五个孩子们，这他们的兄弟呢是神品格善良的人，所以呢这个地方就对他们特别的有益，所以呢主就选择在那个地方作战，因为呢 Dhritarashtra 那边的孩子们呢并不善良。So
Dhritarashtra is in this verse which he's speaking, he's revealing his own materialistic consciousness.
所以在这里面呢，Dhritarashtra在说话的时候已经揭开了他这个非宗教性格的心意。Dhritarashtra
was blind materially, he's also blind spiritually.
Dhritarashtra 不只是说在物质方面是盲目的，因为他瞎了眼，但同时灵性上他也是盲目的。
So he could not understand the position of Lord Krishna, and he could not appreciate the good qualities of the Pandavas.
So he couldn't understand Krishna's position, and he couldn't appreciate the Pandavas' qualities.
He was very attached to his family members.
He was very attached to his family
members. And that is revealed in the very first, in this very first verse, how he separates his sons from the sons of Pandu.
所以这在第一节是很清楚的，就是说，Dhritarashtra已经把自己的家族这个孩子跟这个潘度这边家族的孩子们，把他们隔离了。And
he said, "Mama ka Pandavas chaiva." He said, "What did my sons and the sons of Pandu do?" And he makes the distinction: his sons and the sons of Pandu.
所以这边就说到，就说哦，我的儿子他们在做什么？还有潘度的儿子们，他们现在在做什么？那潘度
the father of the Pandavas, he's already left the world, and Dhritarashtra is their guardian. He should be taking care of the Pandavas.
因为潘度他已经所以隐世过世了，所以照理讲，这个他们亲族呢 ，Dhritarashtra 应该来照顾潘度的儿子们。
But instead, Dhritarashtra is making a distinction between his sons and the sons of Pandu.
但是呢，Dhritarashtra却是做这样分别心，把他的儿子跟潘度的儿子们这样子来分离。
So this is the bodily consciousness. This shows the blindness, the ignorance of Dhritarashtra.
所以这是在身体知觉的概念了。所以呢，就把自己的儿子跟这个潘度的儿子们来这样分离。
So Lord Krishna has come on the battlefield, and Lord Krishna is there with Arjuna, and Lord Krishna is going, he selected this place to speak the Bhagavad
Gita.
Now Krishna could have spoken it before. He didn't have to wait till they got onto the middle of the battle. He could have spoken it earlier.
然而呢，Krishna在之前就可以来讲述了，不必等到面临在战场的时候再讲。But
Lord Krishna is a perfect judge of time and circumstance, and he waits for the appropriate time where the speaking of the Bhagavad Gita will have the greatest impact.
那Krishna是完美的判断者，所以他就等待最好的时机来讲述这个国家梵歌。
And he's with his devotee and friend Arjuna. They've been friends for a long time, and they've often discussed philosophy together.
那Krishna就跟他的奉献者跟他的朋友们呢，就在这里一起。那就像Arjuna他们很久以来都是朋友，常常这边讨论讲话这些事情。So,
as Srila Prabhupada points out in the purport, this Bhagavad Gita is delivering knowledge more than what's in other scriptures.
那Prabhupada在这里指出来，就是《国家梵歌》里面所揭示的知识，比所有的经典都还多。The
greatest thing is to understand that these words of the Bhagavad Gita are the direct words of Lord Krishna, the personality of God.
啊，这是一件很重要、很伟大的一件事。《国家梵歌》里面的字语话语，是Krishna直接所讲述的。Just
like when Lord Krishna speaks, then Srila Vyasa begins by saying Sri Bhagavan Uvacha.
就如Krishna在讲开始讲的时候呢，Vyasa就跟他这样说，Sri Bhagavan Uvacha 这样子。
And Arjuna, when he's speaking, Arjuna is not Bhagavan, so he said simply Sri Arjuna Uvacha.
那这个如果Arjuna讲的时候呢，他不是Bhagavan，所以就是Sri Arjuna Uvacha.
So there's a distinction between the Lord and his devotee. The devotee is not on the same level as the Lord.
所以呢，主呢跟他的奉献者还是有分别的。 奉献者并不跟主是同一个位阶或水平。Lord
Krishna comes into the middle of the battlefield, accompanying his devotee, and he's coming in the middle. He's coming initially simply as a driver, as someone who's not going to participate in the battle.
那么 Krishna 呢，他陪伴着他的奉献者们一起来到这个库鲁支野。那最开始呢，他也没有是要作战，他只是就像一个车夫这样驾着车子过来。He's
not going to participate. That was the agreement initially that Krishna was approached by both Dhritarashtra, by both Duryodhana and Yudhisthira. They both wanted Lord Krishna on their side. But Lord Krishna told them both, but I've decided I'm not going to fight.
那么Krishna来到这边呢，这两边呢，Dhritarashtra还有Yudhisthira两边都要求Krishna站在他们那一边，但是Krishna说呢，我并不准备作战。But
he said, one of you can have my army, and another they can have me, but I won't fight. I'll just simply be the chariot driver. So this was pleasing to Arjuna. He was happy to have Krishna with him, even if he wasn't going to fight. Still, he wanted Krishna to be with him.
但是对Arjuna来讲，是他很高兴的，就是说可以跟Krishna在一起，即便Krishna没有要准备作战。And
for Duryodhana, it was also satisfying to him because he wanted to have Krishna's army. He was more attached to Krishna's army than to Krishna.
那对Duryodhana呢，他也是很满意的，因为他是更依附于Krishna所拥有的士兵呢。He
thought if Krishna's not going to fight, then what's the good of having him on my arm, in my side? He's not going to take part in the battle. He won't help me.
他就想着说，那如果Krishna都不作战，他在我这边有什么用呢？反正他就这样没有用了。So
I'll be happy to have Krishna's army.
所以呢，如果我有Krishna的这些士兵呢，我就很高兴了。So
that's the nature of the non-devotee, the materialistic people. They simply want to enjoy the kingdom of God without God.
所以这是物质主义者的这样的心态，就是他们想要拥有享受神的王国，而不要神的存在。So
Dhritarashtra was supposed to be taking care of the Pandavas like his own sons.
Dhritarashtra 应该是像说自己的儿子一般的来照顾这些Arjuna、Pandu这些五兄弟的。Of
course, there was always tension in the family here, in the Kuru family. There was always tension between the two, the family, the sons of Pandu, the family of Pandu and the family of Dhritarashtra.
但是呢，啊，在这种这个库鲁家族里面的家族里面，总是有存在的紧张关系，就是库鲁Dhritarashtra 的儿子们跟潘度的儿子们之间是存在一种紧张。
Actually, Dhritarashtra was elder. He was the first child born.
实际上 ，Dhritarashtra 是长子，他是他们家里面第一个儿子。
So Dhritarashtra should have been the king, but Dhritarashtra was blind. So how could a blind person be the king?
因为 Dhritarashtra 是长子，本来是嫡长者，接承王位，但是呢，因为他出生就瞎了眼，所以呢说没有办法来接承王位。
And so the second son was Pandu.
那他们家族这个第二个儿子是潘度。
So they thought, well, Pandu, at least he can see. They thought, so let him be the king. He's not the eldest, but he should be the king because he has sight.
那么他们家族就说，那就要让潘度做来接承王位，因为至少他有眼力啊，眼睛可以来看东西。
But when Pandu became the king, at some point he had a curse against him.
那么啊，潘度就成为国王，但是在一个情况里面，他被诅咒了。
And he, for that reason, he had gone off to the countryside. He was living in the countryside.
所以呢，他就必须离开他的王位，去到这个郊外去。
And it happened while he was in the countryside, then the curse took effect, and Pandu died.Well, he was still young, and his children were all young.
那么这个潘度就是在这郊外的时候，他受到诅咒就必死。那当时他也很年轻，而且他自己的孩子也是非常年轻，非常小。
When Kunti was going to give birth to a child, then there was also some competition there because Dhritarashtra's wife Gandhari.She'd also conceived, and she was also going to give birth.
所以潘度的老婆呢，昆蒂当时怀孕了啊。那么，但是在王朝的 Dhritarashtra 的老婆 Gandhari， 她也怀孕了，所以他们变得有种潜在的一种竞争的压力。
But when she heard that Kunti had already delivered a child, she was so angry that she beat the child in her womb.
当他听到昆蒂已经把孩子生出来的时候，这个他很生气呢，就把自己胎中的儿子，就是打了自己胎中的儿子。
And the result was she gave birth to a lump of flesh, rather than a child, she gave birth to a lump of flesh.
他这么生气、嫉妒，然后打了自己胎中的孩子，结果他生出来是一团血肉，本来是应该是一个胎儿，但是变成一团血肉。
But then, by the grace of a great sage, I think it was Vyasa, he arranged that that flesh be divided into 100 pieces, and they were each put in urns, and he brought these 100 pieces to life, and they became the 100 sons of Gandhari.
那么，他自己这样的愤怒，把自己生出了一团血肉啊，那么。由于这个 Vyasa 的，由于圣 Vyasa 的仁慈呢，就是说他这个血肉分成了一百片了。那么 Vyasa 的就仁慈让这一百片的血肉可以完整的复生，成为这个皇后的一百个孩子。
So Gandhari had 100 sons. Kunti had Kunti was left alone because Madri departed along with Pandu. When Pandu left the world, Madri went with him, and Kunti was left to bring up the 5 sons on her own.
那所以 Dhritarashtra 这边的皇后呢，Gandhari 就有一百个儿子了。那么在Pandu 的这边，因为他已经离世了，而且他的其中一个老婆，
Madri
哈，她也跟着。跟着潘度一起，就随丈夫一起死。所以这边呢，昆蒂皇后她自己要来抚养生出来的五个孩子。
So you can see Kunti was struggling certainly on her own to bring up five young children, and Dhritarashtra, being the brother of her husband, being her brother-in-law, he was meant to help her.
所以可以知道呢，昆蒂就自己一个人没有丈夫了，而独立要抚养五个孩子，肯定是很辛苦的过程。那这个丈夫的，就是。
But instead of helping Kunti and taking care of the Pandavas, there was always this conflict going on between the two families, the Kurus and the Pandavas. The competition was always there.
本来这个 Dhritarashtra 应该来照顾自己的 弟妹，还有这弟妹的这个五个儿子哈，阿朱娜他们这五个孩兄弟，那么呢，却没有，而且呢，反而变成说，在这个两个家族里面，经常有冲突、有矛盾，而且不时时不时都有很紧张的现象存在。
Competition. Who's the best at archery? Who's the best in the military arts? Who's the best? The most noble of the Kshatriyas, and so on.
他们之间的冲突跟这个竞争呢，就是说谁是最好的建筑师，谁是最好的军事家，谁是说武术的专家，就是说谁，他们就一直在那边比较竞争。
And of course, the sons of Dhritarashtra were usually always defeated because the Pandavas were so noble and virtuous.
当然呢，这个 Dhritarashtra 的这些儿子们呢，总是被打败，因为呢，潘度这五个孩子是非常高尚品格的啊。They
had Maharaj Yudhisthira, the eldest of the Pandavas. He was the direct, born from the semen of Dharmaraj, the son of Dharmaraj. So he was very, very pious and very religious.
潘度的长子呢，Yudhisthira 是一个非常神圣的君主，他是从宗教之主直接来诞生出来的。And
then you have Bhima, who was very powerful, and nobody could equal him in his strength.
然后这个二哥呢，Bhima非常有力量，没有人可以胜过他的力气。And
you have Arjuna, who was a favorite student of Dronacharya, and he had the blessings of Drona.
然后在三弟呢，就是 Arjuna 呢，他有着他们的老师 Dronacharya 的很大的祝福，是这个老师很喜爱的一个学生。
And so there was always this competition and bitterness between the two sides, between the Pandavas and the Kurus.
所以这个两边呢 ，Pandava 这边跟这个 Kuru 这个家族呢，总是两边。
And so many different incidents had taken place, and at one point even Pandavas had to go into exile for 12 years.
所以呢，这个家族一直在挑衅呢，所以有发生到后来，潘度这个五个儿子必须去流放，去外面流放12年。
And you have also the attempted disrobing of Draupadi, which was a great insult to the wife of the Pandavas.
那么还有也是那种来侮辱这个武兄弟的妻子呢 ，Draupadi 就是故意赌博，然后要求他把他的衣服一层一层的拉下来。
Just as you could imagine, you know, one man, if one woman has five husbands, you know, then definitely people are going to talk. You know, even if 5,000 years ago it was so also.
对，可以去想象，如果一个女人呢有五个丈夫，人们肯定会说话。那更何况在5000年前的时候，这个昆蒂她要服侍五个丈夫。
So there was a lot of criticism and conflict between the Pandavas and the Kurus.
所以就很多的批评的。 言论一直在传流传着，然后呢，这个库鲁家族的人呢，总是一直在挑衅着潘度的这五个儿子。
And ultimately, it came to the crux that they had to go to battle, and they decided Kurukshetra. We'll go to Kurukshetra. We'll fight there.
那这个冲突一再一再的出现，终于到了一个顶点呢，就必须双方直接作战。因此而的库鲁之地的战事就这样发生了。
And both the Kurus and the Pandavas went about collecting support. Come and fight on our side.、
那么这个库鲁这个家族还有潘度这五个孩子，两边都是希望有一个助力来对我们帮我们作战。
Actually, this whole Kurukshetra war was the arrangement of Lord Krishna.To relieve the earth of the burden of all the demonic kshatriyas.
实际上，库鲁之野这个战争呢，是 Krishna 所安排的，是要来缓解这个地球上的负担。
So they all assembled there at the battlefield, and Dhritarashtra, being blind, he cannot go, and he is inquiring from his secretary Sanjay, what is happening.
那么所以这战事就这样发生了。在进行的时候，因为 Dhritarashtra 他眼睛瞎了，看不到，所以他在自己的房间里面问着他的军师 Sanjaya， 跟他报告说现在怎么样了。
And Sanjaya has been gifted with the power of, from Vyas that he can see what's taking place at Kurukshetra.
那像加雅呢，他有 Vyasa 给他特别的能力，让他可以在房间里就可以看到库鲁之野战事的情况。
And although the sons of Dhritarashtra have the much bigger army, still Dhritarashtra is worried about the outcome of the battle.
即便呢 ，Dhritarashtra 他里面的军队的势力非常强大。大过于另外一边，但是这个 Dhritarashtra 还是担心的这战事的结果。
But he doesn't want that there should be any compromise. He's very eager that they should go through. There should be the war. They should fight.
Dhritarashtra 就是那么狠心，不想有任何的妥协，就是说绝对要让这战事发生。
And he wants to hear from Sanjay just.What is happening there? What's the situation?
而且他要从三家那边去听到，就是说，战场上发生了情况。
And the first chapter sets the scene for the battle. What's happening on that battlefield? We'll hear in this first chapter about how the two sides are preparing for the battle.
所以这佛家梵歌这里的第一章就是在布局，就是让战争的一些的情况一一的这样安排出来，然后说接着是怎么样的发生。
On one side you've got the Duryodhan, who wants to encourage his fighters. He's got great fighters like Bhima and Drona, Bhishma rather, and Drona on his side.And he wants to encourage them to fight.
所以一边呢有那个Drona, Bhishma 这些伟大的战士，然后被鼓励着要好好的奋战。
He's also got Karna on his side, but Karna said he won't fight until so long as Bhishma is there. He said if I fight, Bhishma gets all the credit. So he said I'm not going to fight until Bhishma's killed. Then I'm going to come on and fight.
然后呢，还有 Karna 被劝说出来作战，但他说我不要，因为如果说我出来作战的话，等于说帮 Bhishma 建立功劳，除非 Bhishma 他没有出现在战场，或是他走开了，这样我才会出来。
So you can see, even on one side, there's so much politics between these people.
所以可以看到，即使对战的一边，任何一边里面都有存在的很多，政治小政治在分群组。
So this Bhagavad Gita is spoken here in this holy place of Kurukshetra, and it's the ultimate message of politics. All politicians, they should learn the Bhagavad Gita.
So, the Bhagavad Gita, 就这样的所谓各种战事安排都是这个都是政治一开场就是政治的布局所以所有的政治家政治人物都应该来研究国家梵歌
What will they learn from Bhagavad Gita? They will learn that everything belongs to Krishna
那这些政治家可以从国家梵歌里面学到什么 他们可以学到所有一切都属于Krishna的
And that ultimately we should all surrender to Krishna
而且最终而言我们都必须要向Krishna来臣服
We should give up our material motivation which is blinding us which is putting us into more and more ignorance
那我们都应该放弃物质的动机 因为物质欲望,物质动机在使我们盲目
So Krishna is speaking this Bhagavad Gita to open our eyes, to give us knowledge, to understand the actual situation
所以Krishna就讲述国家梵歌来打开我们的眼界,就是让我们来了解真正的情况
Unfortunately, people are so stubborn, they don't want to see the truth, they don't want to admit that there is some other
不幸的是人们是不想要看到真理不想要看到真实情况他们想要别的东西
But Krishna is so kind He comes, He personally speaks the Bhagavad Gita and then He sends also His devotees also to speak the message of the Bhagavad Gita
然后Krishna是这么样的友善那么仁慈他自己来讲述这个国家梵歌
And he comes himself as a devotee, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he comes to show us all how to surrender to Krishna. Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita, then he came 500 years ago to show us how follow the
Bhagavad-gita.所以Krishna很仁慈的来讲述了国家梵歌，然后在500年前他自己亲自出现，教导我们怎么样来遵循国家梵歌。
So this Bhagavad-gita, this is very important message for all of us.
所以这就是国家梵歌是非常重要，对我们来讲都是非常重要的讯息。We
want to hear it regularly. Regularly, we have to hear and hear and remind ourselves.
所以我们必须要非常规律的一再一再的聆听来提醒我们自己
Okay, are there any questions?
有没有任何问题?
Maharaj Hare Krishna, thank you so much, nice lecture At the beginning you mentioned that Krishna has created the time and circumstances that this time will come then he will give this message of Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna So if we compare ourselves with Arjuna so we are fortunate enough that this knowledge is already there we just need to surrender someone bona fide spiritual master then it's free that time like you mentioned that time it was Krishna has created the time and circumstances but for us so what how we should take it like we are really more fortunate than Arjuna or we are the unfortunate souls Thank you so much, Maharaj.
就是刚刚有说到这个，像库鲁战场那个时候的时间跟地点，由Krishna亲自来安排决定的。然后Krishna自己来才有这个情境之后，才对Arjuna讲述。所以呢，看起来我们似乎是更加的幸运，因为Krishna已经把国家梵歌讲述出来了，我们有这个讯息。 或者是说我们不幸没有去利用获取这个知识，那应该要怎么样来接受或是了解国家梵歌的教导？
Well, if we take advantage of the Bhagavad Gita and learn, try to follow, then you're very fortunate.
如果说我们好好的利用国家梵歌的教导，而且去学习去实践，那你是非常的幸运的。
But if we don't take advantage and we neglect the, to the, we don't understand the importance of this, then we're unfortunate.
但是如果没有利用这个国家梵歌，没有去了解去实践的话，那我们就很不幸了。
Chaitanya Charitamrita also describes about fortunate souls.
在永恒的 Chaitanya 经里面有描述着幸运的灵魂们。
Brahmanda Brahmite Konya Bhagyavanji Guru Krishna Prasadi Pai Bhaktilata Bish. The living entity is moving through many different universes, taking birth many times in different bodies. But when he is fortunate,then he contacts the devotees, this pure devotee, the spiritual teachers, and he gets the seed of devotion.
是这样子。这一段是在永恒切当牙经讲到，一个个体生物，个体生物一个个体灵魂在宇宙各地徘徊游荡，一个幸运的灵魂有幸的遇到一个主的奉献者，这个奉献者会把。就是传扬给他，就是让他去接触到 Krishna， 认识到 Krishna。
So by the grace of Krishna, you're fortunate. You contacted the Krishna consciousness movement, and you have the opportunity to get the seed of devotion.
所以同时呢，也是由于 Krishna 仁慈，一个人遇到主的奉献者有这样的幸运。
And if we don't take advantage, then we're unfortunate.
那如果没有好好运用这样的幸运的话，那其实是不幸的。
You're given the chance, but you don't take it.
就是你已经被给予机会了，可是你没有去接受。
Just like we say, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink. It's up to the horse.
就好像说，我们可以把马带到这个水槽前面，但是你没办法叫马去喝水。
So we have to ourselves want to take up.The Krishna conscious process.
所以是我们自己要必须是我们自己来想要接受这个 Krishna 知觉。
Srila Prabhupada was giving initiation to some people one time, and he told them, he said, "I'm doing the ritual." He said, "The rest is up to you and your determination."
像风花有一次在启迪门徒的时候，就跟门徒就说：“我只是在做这个仪式，其他所有一切就看你自己的决心了。”
Right? Spiritual masters just doing a ritual, but it's up to every individual themselves. They have to be very determined to take up this process.
灵性导师只是在做一个仪式而已。那么就完全看取决于这个门徒他的决心他坚定的决心。
You can't just say, "Well, Guru's mercy."You know, if I chant my rounds or not, it's a guru's man. It's not. It's up to you, yourself. Yeah, are you determined? Are you going to do it?
所以呢，如果说我念诵或不念诵呢，就看 guru 的仁慈吧。那不是这样子，那是看你自己要不要，愿不愿意去做。
Are you going to tolerate all the obstacles on the path?
所以我们想要，我们要愿意来。忍耐在这条路径所有的障碍困难。
There will be obstacles. There will be difficulties. It won't be all so easy.
这一路上总会有障碍，有困难，不会说一路都很容易的。
But we have to have that determination to want to go on.
但是我们必须要有那个决心，就是我们真的一直想要前进。
Even though we may have many difficulties and fall downs on the path, but we keep going.
即便呢，我们有很多周围有很多的困难，或者说我们偶尔会有一些不足或是堕落的情况，但是我们还是决心的一直想要前进。
I want to give this one life to Krishna.
就是我要这一生，我这一生完全交付给 Krishna。
Yes,
Maharaj. Yes. Maharaj, I have a question. Because Krishna knows Arjuna so long time, so why he teach him in that time, in that place? I mean that before the battle and in the battlefield, and why Arjuna, not Yudhishthira or other brothers?
Well, because Arjuna and Krishna were very intimately related to each other. They were of the same age. Bhima and Yudhisthira were older, Nakula and Sahadev were younger, but Arjuna and Krishna, they were the same age, so they were very close to each other.
Arjuna and
Wherever Krishna goes, Arjuna goes with him.
Mm. Krishna 去到哪, Arjuna 都跟着一起去。
Not only on this planet, other universes also. Mm.
这情况不止在我们这个地球, 而且在其他的宇宙里。
So Lord Krishna tells Arjuna, many, many births both you and I have had, Arjuna. I can remember them, but you cannot.
所以在《普迦梵歌》里面，Krishna也说到，就是说，很多事，很多事了，我们在一起，而且过去所有一切我都记得，但你并不记得。
So this birth is only one part of our journey.
所以我们这一世只是我们这一段路程的一个部分。
We have to be introspective and think about our spiritual nature, our spiritual self. Our real self is spiritual, not just some body, physical body.
So we must be self-reflection.
So Krishna and Arjuna, they are like Nara and Narayan.
所以Krishna跟Arjuna他们两个就像Nara跟Narayan。Lord
Krishna is Narayan and Arjuna is Nara.
所以Krishna就是Narayan，那Arjuna是Nara。
So they're always together.
就两个都是一直在一起的。
Okay, any other question?
我可以问一个比较不一样的问题。我的小侄女问，我们是不是有守护灵？
Niece asked if we have a gardener follow accompany with us.
A what? A gardener?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you can have if you want. Do you want to take protection? Krishna is with us, right? Krishna is with us.
是可以的，如果你愿意的话，而且同时 Krishna 就一直跟我们在一起。
In the heart as the super soul.
Krishna 在我们心里是超灵的，这样子。
He says he's the best friend.
也是我们的最好的朋友。
Your other friends come and go.
其他的朋友来来去去的。But
there's one friend who is with you all the time in this material world.
有一个朋友在物质世界里都一直永远都是也跟你在一起的。And
he's the best friend.
而且他是最好的朋友。And
he's directing us and reminding us, trying to help us to go back to Krishna.
而且他在 指引着我们，也在保护着我们，让我们可以回到Krishna那儿去。So
he's the real guardian.
所以他真的就是我们的守护园丁，我们的守护灵。
Yes. Yes.
听到不一样讲的是对的，因为守护灵，因为我在百货公司上班，我上个月，然后我们隔壁专柜小姐她竟然看到我后面有只大狮子，非常大，就是尼熊啊，很凶，然后她就吓死了，她说你不要靠近我，你后面有一只大狮子，好大，好恐怖。后来我拿那个尼熊啊，我拿那个图片给她看，她吓到，她说对对对，就是她。然后她看到我黑光，然后看到黑光里面是有 Krishna 还有白色的 Radha， 但她看不到。可是他看到我身上有白的、黑的，还有金色的光。他看到明星好大、好凶哦！他说：“你后面是大狮子，吓死人了，恐怖死了！你不要靠近我，你好恐怖。”然后来我拿，他说是我的守护神，我的 Krishna 的愤怒尊，生气的时候他才会显现很凶的样子。他说：“对对对，就是他，就是青椒白呀。”他说：“这只狮子。”然后我吓一跳，我说：“对啊，我说你好棒棒，你看得到。”明星哈，我说我邀请他来我们庙，那个带罗克群啊，然后他就是对我笑，他就说我是个很善良的人，他说因为他会看得到那些有瞬间都会看得到，啊，因为他也是有修行的，啊，然后我跟他说你很棒棒，他看到狮子的时候他吓一跳，就是那个我们神坛上的那个明星哈，他说你好凶哦，你
马尔奇听懂了，马尔奇已经。听懂了，
我好开心哦！
了解了解了了解了，
对啊，你很虔诚，明星号就会保护着，我觉得真的很棒。
Yes, very good. Okay, so burnishing it will protect you.Yeah, just like a lion, lions can be very ferocious to others, but they're very kind to their own cubs. So Prabhupada said in the same way, Lord Nrisimhadeva is very ferocious to the demons, but he's very kind to the devotees.
嗯，就像狮子一样呢，它是让一般人都觉得非常狰狞可怕的害怕的。可是对他自己的小狮子呢，他是非常亲切温柔的，所以包括就是说，就像朱女士跟对恶魔来说是非常狰狞可怕的，可是对于他的奉献者呢，朱女士跟是非常的这样的温柔，这样子的温柔啦，这样保护着。
So the devotees have nothing to fear. We just offer our obeisances to Lord Shiva.
所以奉献者是不应该有任何恐惧害怕，我们只要就像主啊，主你心跟着来顶拜，向他臣服。
Did you offer your obeisances?
你有来做臣服顶拜吗？你有没有向你心跟着顶拜臣服？
有啊，早晚都那个点灯啊。
早晚
不假，然后那个明星怕的那个祷文啊，都念啊。
可是你看到他的时候，你已经拜他。
你看到的时候，
你
边顶拜。
有，而且今年的那个林星哈的那个 birthday， 我看到他真的显现一个那个好大一个角，很大的那个莲花组，然后他是穿老师那个颜色的那个，然后那个脚好大，真的好大，不是我们一般人的脚。
非常大的手还是脚脚莲花组他的右脚短我想看他的莲花组就很开心今天是的是的是的是的是的是的是的是的
Motivated interpretations.
在这个要这今天这节诗里面的要旨，包括说一个人不应该对有任何的个人的解释啊，个人的动机。
Well, some people take advantage of the Bhagavad Gita to present their own philosophy or their own political purposes.
因为有一些人呢，他们用佛教梵歌里面的字语啊，词句字语来为自己做借口，或者做他政治的一个标题。
They write a commentary on the Bhagavad Gita, but they don't have anything to say about Lord Krishna. They don't respect Lord Krishna, but they just simply take the message of Bhagavad Gita to present their own ideas.
就好像说他们对佛家梵歌的这些作为一个解说，但是没有呈现出这个 Krishna 的这一些，只是作为他们要所谓政治上的理由一个什么借口或是。
They give Bhagavad Gita as they want it to be, not as it is, not as Krishna spoke it, but as they want it to be.
那他们去呈现佛教梵歌，就是以他们自己想要说的、想要表达方式去做，而不是把佛教梵歌原本原意这样的呈现出来。
So when that happens, then there's no more potency in the message.
所以发生那样的事的话，就是说佛教梵歌里面就失去了它的宗旨了，没有里面的钥匙了。
And you can read in the fourth chapter how in the course of time the message was passed through saintly kings, but they changed things, the message was lost. So yoga brastopajaya, Lord Krishna had to come again and reestablish the teaching.
那可以在梵歌的第四章里面又看到里面 Krishna 描述的就是说这个佛教梵歌的教导已经传承到一些国王们之间，可是后来又流失了，那么 Krishna 呢自己亲自出现再把这个佛教梵歌再传述出来。
Okay, thank you. Any other question?All right. Okay, finish. Thank you, Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Please, for the next question, Maharaj ki.
Jai.
Jai.
Thank you.